And a good May 31st, 2020. It's Sunday, the last day of May. How about that? My name is Jewel, and this is a tropical update for today. And what do we have? We have Tropical Storm Amanda right in here, as you can see. Now, the little system we were watching out here, it's already dissipated. As I did forecast, it's going to bring some rain up in these areas, but then that's about it. No big wind problem, just a little rain coming up your way up in this area of Canada, and then it's going to move on offshore. But we do have Tropical Storm Amanda that we are going to need to watch because it could get in the Gulf. Now, from the National Hurricane Center right in here, it's looking like this. The Eastern Pacific Tropical Storm Amanda is centered inland over southeastern Guatemala, and it's forecast to weaken into a remnant low or maybe even dissipate over Guatemala and southeastern Mexico by tonight. But here's a clincher, folks. However, the remnants of Amanda, they're expected to move northwestward with a broader area of disturbed water. Those little gyres that I showed you a couple of days ago in the tropical update. Now, this could possibly emerge over the southeastern Bay of Campeche by tomorrow. Now, if the remnants move back over water, environmental conditions appear conducive to support some redevelopment of the system while it moves a little through the middle of next week, and I'll tell you about that too. Regardless of the redevelopment, heavy rainfall is likely to continue over portions of southern Mexico during the next few days. Now, it's looking like in 2 days it has a 40% chance, and in 5 days it has a 50% chance of possibly forming. We can see we do have tropical storm warnings up all around in Mexico, all the way over to El Salvador. These are tropical storm warnings. 7 a.m. for this morning, you can see where it was. It should form a little bit into this depression area, but then it should weaken, as you can see, looking like it's going to curve back around. Now, I'm over at my Fox right now, Hurricane Center, and this is the Caribbean GFS. Not for all the states up here. So we're going to watch this go through right in this area. I want you to see it. However, the European model has this thing a little bit different. And it's looking like on the European model, I'll show you in a moment, it could bring a lot of rain, possibly a few wind gusts by Sunday, somewhere between Beaumont, Texas and Mobile, Alabama. But it's like I'm favoring at this time more of this model and the WRF tropical model as to where this may go. We do have this huge high pressure over here, as you can see. It's going to kind of keep it down some, so it can't get up but so far till. But let's just turn it on right quick, and I'm just going to let it roll through. You can see your timestamp here, and I'll show you other things in just a moment. But it's looking like, for the most part, the storm, Tropical Storm Amanda, it's embedded in the eastern area of a larger cyclonic gyre centered over eastern Mexico. Now, the cyclone looks like it's going to remain trapped, just like I showed you, with the larger gyre for the next few days, resulting in north-northeastward to northward motion for today, followed by a much slower northwestward to westward motion by Tuesday and Wednesday, with the remnant low possibly emerging over the Bay of Campeche. That's what we've got to look out for. If it does merge, it should happen on just a few days from now. It's looking like the Bay of Campeche area, which could result, if it gets there, it could have the formation of a new tropical cyclone. Now, winds in this system right now are 40 miles per hour. It's looking like they should dissipate through the next 72 hours. But you can see right here as this is going through, I want to stop it and click it up a little bit faster while we're on this model. Once again, this is the Caribbean GFS model. Here we go, right in here. You can see it right up in these areas. But when we get on up here, you can see it does maybe come up, and it does try to form right around here. Moving over closer to Texas, but then watch what happens. It goes up a little bit. Still a rainmaker. You can see your barometric pressure over here. Might have some tropical storm wind gust in it. Don't think it'll be a tropical storm, but then it gets put. We got a high coming. It's trapped again. Trapped again. Now, it starts to try to form. We really have to watch the system. But it keeps going south because this high is keeping it out of this area. This high is pushing it down, keeping it out of this area. It all depends on if the systems move at the rate that they look like they are now. Now, when we go over to the tropical WRF model, it's looking pretty accurate. Now, it only goes out for 72 hours, but we don't need to go out any further than 72 hours because when we get too far out, we don't know what's going to happen. You can't do it but so far out to have any kind of accuracy at all. You can see your timestamp right here. You can see your little system right here. Here we go. We're going to move it on up. And let's see what this model is showing. This one is looking like it's pretty much in agreement with the National Hurricane Center. Can see it moving right along there. It moves out into the Gulf a little. Then it starts to come back down, just like that map of the tracking map. See it right in here from the National Hurricane Center showed us for the next few days. We'll run it back one more time. And here we are, the end of 72 hours. It should be here. Still need to watch it though. Especially if you're in any of the Texas to Alabama areas, I think. You see this high pressure is keeping Florida covered. Looks like it's keeping most of Georgia, Alabama, and Mississippi covered. But we still have this little gap here. Now, on the European model, I've got it set for Tuesday. You can see it does have the same thing that the Caribbean GFS and the tropical WRF model had as it's coming back down in these areas. I'll just push it up some. There's a little bit of difference. It's pretty accurate. They're pretty all together up until we get around. Well, you can see it dissipates also by Wednesday. Looks like it's dissipating. Here we go. Still just it's just a low. But you know how these lows have been hanging on. That's why I want everybody to be aware of what's going on. See, here it is. It's just a low pressure still. You don't have to worry about anything except people in Mexico and all these areas right in here down to Guatemala and all these areas up in this area. You guys are going to get so much rain, you can have some landslide and some mudslides. So please be aware if you're in any of these areas right in here for the next few days. But I want to show you what happens as we move up in time. When we get to, say, next Sunday, a week from today. Now, this is just the European model once again. You can see it's still a low pressure system, okay? But it looks like it's got some pretty heavy rain in it. And we'll move up to around 10 or 11 Sunday, next Sunday, the 7th. And as we'll take the pressure granites off here, this is the larger gyre that the smaller one gets into. And it's going to be bringing, looking like it this time, some very heavy rain up in these areas. I'll try to make it a little bit bigger for you and then move it over so you can get some actual pinpoint locations. And here we go. Here's New Orleans. And here is Mobile. Remember I said anywhere from Beaumont, Texas. I blew it up a little further. Here's the center of circulation. Just a low pressure at this time. But folks, we need to watch it. We'll move up just a little bit more to around 9 p.m. next Sunday. Now you can see why I said, look at all of those very, very heavy rain bands up in Mississippi and around Mobile. New Orleans, you're going to get a lot of rain, and that center is still just right offshore. But so far as the winds go, with the European model, if this does make up and exist, which it looks like it could very well, only time will tell. We'll have to wait and see. Sustained winds when they come in, 32 miles per hour. Does it have any higher wind gust in it at this time? In the same area, looking like 54 mile per hour wind gust. So now you know why I'm saying we need to watch this. So, with that all said and done, it's going to be a week that we're going to really have to watch and see what's happening, folks, when it comes to tropical weather. If you live in any of the Gulf Coast states, please be aware of what's going on. And I hope and pray, and I know that all of you do by now, have your hurricane hits kits together and your hurricane plans together. I will keep my eyes on this. Do not worry, I will post anything I see indifference about it. So, with all that said and done, you have a good day, a safe day, a blessed day. Don't forget to subscribe. Thank you so much for everything you do for me. Peace, love, and kindness to each and every one of you. Thanks so much for watching.